Hi children, this is your ANR sir with a new lesson for class 7th, chapter 2, page number 43 and exercise number 3. First problem, find each of the following products. Find each of the following products. A 5/6 into 7/11. What we have to do? When two fractions are given and you are asked to find their product, you have to multiply both numerator and denominator. So 5 3 = 35 by 6 11 = 66. So now the second problem, 6 × 1/5. Here 6 means what? 6 by 1. So 6 into 1, 6. 5 into 1, 5. Now, third problem. 2 × 1/3 into 3 × 1/5. So, these two are mixed fractions. What we have to do? We have to convert these mixed fractions into improper fractions. So 3 × 2 = 6 plus 1, 7/3. 5 3 = 15 plus 1, 16/5. So if you multiply 7 16 = how much? 7 6 = 42. 2 4. 7 1 = 7 plus 4. 7 plus 4. 11. By 3 5 = 15. So now second question. What is your second question? Multiply and reduce to lowest form. What we have to do? We have to multiply and then we have to reduce also. And reduce to lowest form. So what is your first problem? 2/3 into 5 1/5. So here one fraction is proper fraction and other one is mixed one. So mixed one you have to change into improper fractions. How? 5 5 = 25 plus 1, 26/5. So now you have to multiply both numerator and denominator. 2 × 26. How much? 52/15. Second question. What is your second question? 2 by 7 × 1/3. 2 by 7 × 1/3. What you need to do? You have to multiply both numerator and you have to multiply denominator. 2 1 = 2. 7 3 = 21. Now let us go to next example. 9/3 × 5/5. 9 by 3 into 5 by 5. Clear? So you have to multiply it and you have to take, you have to reduce into lowest form. So 3 1 ja, 3 3 ja, and 5 1 ja, 5 1 ja. So what is left? 3. Next question. 0 3. Next question. 0 3. What is it? Which one is greater? Which one is greater? So what are those fractions? 2 by 5 of 4 by 7 or 3 by 4 of 1 by 2. First, what we need to do, we have to simplify this. 2 by 5 of 1 by 4 by 7 means what? You have to multiply both numerators and denominators and you have to take. So 2 4 ja 8, 7 5 ja 35, or 3 1 ja 3, 4 2 ja 8. So which one is greater? We cannot say because our denominators are not equal. So what we need to do, we have to make the denominators same. For this, what we need to do, we have to multiply both numerator and denominator of the first fraction by 8 and by 35 to the second fraction. That means 8 into 8 by 35 into 8 or 3 into 35 by 8 into 35. Now see, 8 is 64 by 35 by 35 into 8 or 35 3 ja, how much? 3 5 ja 15, 1 3 3 ja 9 1 10 by 8 into 35. Because our numerators are same, so that number which has greater numerator is greater. So here what happens? This is greater. That means 105 by 8 into 35 is greater than 64 by 35 by 35 into 8. So what is this? This is this one. That means 3 by 4 of 1 by 2 is greater than 2 by 5 of 4 by 7. Understood? First, what we have to do? We have to do the simplification. So, 2 4 ja 8, 5 7 ja 35. This side also. 3 1 ja 3, 4 2 ja 8. After that, we have to try to make the denominators same. For this, first fraction is to be multiplied both numerator and denominator by 8. And for second one, you have to multiply both numerator and denominator by 35. Clear? So, after this, the numerator which is greater, that fraction is greater. So, this is greater, 105 by 8 into 35. So what is this? 3 by 4 of 1 by 2. So 3 by 4 of 1 by 2 is greater than 2 by 5 of 4 by 7. I think you understood the problem. So now let us go to the next problem. B. 1 by 2 of 4 by 7 or 2 by 3 of 3 by 7, which one is greater? 1 by 2 of 4 by 7 is greater or 2 by 3 of 3 by 7 is greater? So let us simplify this. 1 by 2 into 4 by 7 or 2 by 3 into 3 by 7. Here 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4. Here 3 and 3 both cancel. So what you got? 2 by 7 and this side also 2 by 7. So both are equal. That means 1 by 2 of 4 by 7 is equal to 2 by 3 of 3 by 7. Clear? So now let us go to fourth question. What is the fourth question? I read. Listen. Rehna works 2.5 hours each day on her embroidery. She completes the work in 7 days. How many hours did she take to complete her work? Let me read it again. Rehna works 2.5 hours each day on her embroidery. She completes the work in 7 days. How many hours did she take to complete her work? That means, how much part of the work she would complete every day? Every day, Rehna works for how many hours? Works for 2.5 hours. Clear? Every day Rehna works for 2.5 hours. So here like that, how many hours did she work? So for 7 days, she would work 7 into 2.5 hours. Understood? For 7 days, she would work 7 into 2.5 hours. That means 7 into, let us change this into improper fraction. 4 plus 1, 5 by 2. That means 35 by 2 hours. So, here, Rehna completes the work in 35 by 2. That means, let us change this into mixed fraction. 17, 1 by 2 hours. Clear? Listen. So every day, Rehna works for 2.5 hours. So, in order to complete that work, she took 7 days. In order to complete that work, she took 7 days. So, for 7 days, how many hours did she work? 7 into 2.5 hours. And let us change this 2.5 hours into a mixed fraction. So, 7 into 5 by 2. So, 35 by 2 hours. So, Rehna completes the work. In hours it is asked. In how many hours? 35 by 2 hours. 35 by 2 hours means what? 17 and half hours. I think you understood the problem. So, now next problem. What is the next problem? A truck runs
8 kilometers using 1 liter of petrol. You see, vehicles use petrol or diesel to run. So this truck runs 8 kilometers using 1 liter of petrol. So how much distance will it cover using 10 2 by 3 liters of petrol? 1 liter, 8 kilometers. 10 by 2, 10 and 2 by 3 liters, how many kilometers? So let me write in statement. Truck consumes 1 liter petrol to run 18 kilometers. How many kilometers? 8 kilometers. Clear? So 10 2 by 3 liters. How much distance it would cover? Consuming 10 and 2 by 3 liters of petrol. How much distance? How much distance it covers? When it consumes 10 2 by 3 liters of petrol, that means 10 2 by 3 into 8 kilometers. 10 2 by 3 means what? 30 plus 2, 32 by 3 into 8. So 8 2 ja 16, 1, 24 plus 1, 25 by 3. So if you change this into decimals, 8 ja 24, 16, 5 is 1 is left, so 3 like the recurring decimal you get kilometers. So the truck what runs 85.33 kilometers consuming 10 2 by 3 liters of petrol. I think you understood the problem. Clear? So now let us go to 6th question. What is the 6th question? Raja walks 1.5 meters in 1 second. Raja walks 1.5 meter in 1 second. See. So now, how much distance will he walk in 15 minutes? So here his speed is given in seconds. And you are asked to find the distance when he walks for 15 minutes. So you know, for each, in each minute, how many seconds are there? 60. So first of all, we have to find the distance Raja walks in 1 minute. So Raja walks, let us change this into improper fraction. 2 plus 1, 3 by 2 meter into 60 in 1 minute. I think you understood here the logic. In 1 second, he covers 1 by 2 meters. How many seconds are there in 1 minute? 60. So what you did, you multiplied by 60 in order to get the distance covered by Raja in 1 minute. So if you simplify, this and this will cancel. 30. 30 into 3, 90 meters. So in 1 minute, Raja travels 90 meters. So in 15 minutes, Raja covers how much? 90 into 15 meter. How much? Multiply this. 0, 15 nines are 135. So many meters. If you convert this into kilometers, 1.35 kilometers. So Raja covers 1.35 kilometers in what time? In 15 minutes. So what we did? First of all, the distance covered is given per second. So we converted that into minutes. So what we did? We multiplied by 60. So the distance covered by Raja per 1 minute is, we got 90 meters. So for 15 minutes, again we have to multiply by 15. So how much you got? 1350 meters. And when we convert this into kilometers, we got 1.35 kilometers. Okay. So only one problem is left, and today we complete, and after that we call the day. 7th one. So what we have to do here, a box is given and you have to fill that box in order to satisfy that statement. 2 by 3 into a box. Here you need to write some fraction is equal to 20 by 21. So here, what is your numerator? 20. So by multiplying what number to 2, you get 20? 10. Here you got 21. By multiplying what number to 3, you get 21? 7. So in this box, you have to write 10 by 7. And your last sum, 5 by 7 into box by 5. Understood? Is equal to 3 by box. Listen. So when you do the simplification, this and this will cancel. So here in the numerator you got 3. So you need to take 3 here. And in the denominator you got here 7. So here you get 7. So I think you understood my explanation. Okay. So tomorrow again I come up with a new lesson. Till then, have a nice day. Bye bye. And thank you for your listening.